Hello guys, welcome back. In this video we'll be learning two concepts. First, what is vapor pressure? Then we'll learn how is the precipitation occurs. Now if you see the cloud has many particles apart from the water vapor, water droplets, ice crystal. It has, you know, some other gases also. Each of these particles exert their pressure on the surface or any particle, and the sum is equal to the P atmosphere. The pressure exerted singly by the water vapor is known as a vapor pressure. When the cloud is saturated, then the pressure exerted is known as saturated vapor pressure. Okay? So, I need to tell you one concept before starting understanding the precipitation, that here is ice and this is the water droplet. Since this is water, since the air above the water is warmer and hence the holding capacity of air above the water is higher, hence the saturation vapor pressure over the water surface would be higher as compared to that of ice crystal. This also means that it takes more vapor molecules to saturate air above the water than the ice, because the temperature is higher, than the bucket size here, as I already explained, would be higher. Okay. Next we move to precipitation, but before moving to precipitation, I want to know why is there that we are reading the two hypotheses. Okay, what I want to explain is, if the air has got, you know, evaporated and it has formed clouds, why doesn't the clouds give the rain immediately upon condensation? Okay, there are two main problems with the condensation. Firstly, the condensed water droplets or ice crystals are very, very small. The small ice crystal and water droplets undergo problems such as, when they fall, they undergo warmer layers below. Hence, they are again evaporated and are again sent back to where they came from. Secondly, due to high convection currents, the turbulence causes them to rise again to the height. Hence, we are coming to a fact that the condensed water droplets and ice crystals must be heavier in order to tackle these two problems, these two challenges. Okay? So whatever theory we'll be studying how does a water droplet or ice crystals increase its mass, increase its size. Okay. So based on this, there are two theories. First is the collision coalescence hypothesis and second is the ice crystal formation hypothesis. Collision coalescence hypothesis, since these theory was developed by the scientists observing the tropical area clouds, and the tropical area clouds primarily has the water droplets and the vapors, so it has a natural limitation that it doesn't include ice crystals, it ignores ice crystals. So let's start with the theory. This theory says that clouds, you know, upon rubbing with each other gain opposite charges. These opposite charges causes them to collide. The water droplets on collision coalesce and they form bigger water droplets. Hence, larger they grow, faster they grow. The second hypothesis is ice crystal formation hypothesis, also known as Bergeron-Findesen hypothesis. This theory was developed by the observation of the temperate clouds. Hence, This has ice crystal, this has water vapor, and this has vapors. Now, you will say that why does it have water droplets? The answer would be, at heights, the air pressure is reduced significantly, and hence, water exists even at minus 10, minus 20 degrees Celsius, because these are super cooled water droplets. The decreased pressure decreases their melting point. As you can see here, there are also ice crystals. Now, the theory says that the ice crystals and the super cooled water droplet, they undergo a competition to grab as much as water vapor so as to fall on the ground. But theory says that ice crystal starts taking lead because, as I have already explained, the vapor pressure over the ice crystal is lesser as compared to that of water droplet. So all the vapors, you know, converge on this low pressure. Soon the vapor diminishes. Upon decreasing concentration of vapor, water comes in charity mode and water starts evaporating because the latent heat of sublimation released by the water vapor causes it to evaporate. Hence, ice grow at the cost of water droplet. Such a wonderful display of team spirit. Snowflakes are formed. These snowflakes fall, but they, because of turbulence, they again rise. During rise, they again gain size, and fall, they again gain size. So, snowflake converts to hail and sleet. Now, when these hail, sleet, snowflake fall, they melt and form water droplets. This is what the ice crystal formation hypothesis says. So, you will be asking now which of these two hypotheses to follow. So, at present, it understood that a mix of these two hypotheses provides a more comprehensive understanding of the process of precipitation. Okay, that's all. Thank you.